Biology.
Hello there and welcome again to this class. So in this class we're going to discuss about transport of carbon 4 oxide in the blood. So you see that the carbon 4 oxide diffuses out of the cell into the tissue fluid. So from here it diffuses into the bloodstream, and about only 85% of the carbon 4 oxide is transported inside the red blood cells. It is only about 10% that is transported as carbinohemoglobin, whereby this is hemoglobin which is combined with carbon 4 oxide. And about only 5% is transported by plasma in form of weak carbonic acid, and that is H2CO3. So let's now look at the transportation of oxygen. So how is oxygen transported in the body? And then we'll see that oxygen mainly diffuses into the alveolar capillaries down the concentration gradient across the capillary endothelium, or the layman's term is called the plasma. So after that, let's now look at the functions of the blood. And we'll see that the first function of the blood serves as transporting a medium for transportation of different materials in the body. And also the blood serves as a defense mechanism whereby it contains white blood cells to fight different harmful microorganisms in the body. Also we see that the blood serves, it produces different antibodies for the body. Also the other function of the blood is that it has platelets which mainly reduce excess bleeding. And then finally, the blood contains different mechanisms for temperature regulation. So far from the blood, let's now look at the lymphatic system, whereby we see that the lymphatic system, this is mainly the network of vessels through which lymph drains from the tissues into the blood. So they have different swellings called the lymph nodes, which mainly produce different antibodies. An example of the different antibodies we have the lymphocytes. So what is the tissue fluid that we have mentioned, the tissue fluid, though we had discussed this in the previous classes? So the tissue fluid, you say that this is the part of the blood which has filtered out of the narrow capillaries into the intercellular air spaces. So the tissue fluid has many different functions. So the first function of the tissue fluid is that it bathes the cell, whereby oxygen and carbon dioxide will diffuse out of the cells. So also we see that the tissue fluid, the other function is that different cells obtain nutrients from it. And also you see that cells will release their waste products for transportation in the tissue fluid. And then apart from that, we see that the tissue fluid also serves the function of giving all the cells and the tissue different nutrients. So from the tissue fluid, let's now look at the lymph. So what is lymph? So if you have been asked what is lymph, you'll say that this is an excess tissue fluid that has filtered out of the intercellular air spaces into the lymph vessels. So the lymph is usually low in oxygen and carbon 4 oxide as compared to the blood. So however, we see that the lymph contains the lymphocytes. And the question to ask ourselves here is, how is the lymph formed? So let's look at now the formation of lymph, whereby we see that the high pressure at the arterial end of the capillaries forces water and small amount of solute out of the capillaries, therefore forming the tissue fluid. So the excess tissue fluid does not get back into the capillaries from the lymph. However, the lymph is drained in the lymphatic vessels, and that's how the first part of forming the lymph. Then again, we see that in this lymph, the fats are added and then it is returned back to the subclavian vein. Let's now look at the roles of the lymphatic system. So what are the roles of the lymphatic system? What's the importance of the lymphatic system? So the first one, we say that the lymphatic system traps and destroys harmful bacteria from the body, and that's the function of the lymphocytes contained inside the lymph. So also the lymphatic system, it mainly facilitates the transportation of different hormones from the endocrine glands to the different blood vessels located in the body.
The roles of the lymphatic system. So as you can see, the diagram on the right is the diagram of the human body showing all the positions of the lymphatic system as well as the lymph nodes. So getting back to the roles of the lymphatic system, so the first role, we say that it traps and destroys harmful bacteria from the body. So the second role is that it absorbs digested lipids, glycerol, and fatty acids from the body. The third role of the lymphatic system is that It facilitates the transportation of dissolved hormones from the endocrine gland of the brain to all the blood vessels in the body. So the third role of the lymphatic system is that it supplies materials for the repair of the injured tissues and body vessels. So the third role we have, the last role we have, the formation of barriers whereby they prevent inflammation or the production of antibodies for destroying various pathogens in the body. Biology.